What's up, guys? Today we're working on this Mitsubishi 4G63 6-bolt cylinder head. It's a factory virgin stock head just to take off. We're going to bust this thing apart, assess it, and if everything looks good, we're going to turn it into one of our gnarly heads, which is like a max effort 6-bolt deal, big horsepower, talking 1500 plus capable 4-cylinder stuff. So I'm going to get this thing tore down. Check it out. So this thing's already looking a bit better than it did before, but definitely not 100%, obviously, far from it. But we got it all apart. So far, the only thing I see as an issue is a broken off exhaust stud and the other exhaust stud that I still haven't gotten out. So I'm going to stick this thing in the hot tank. I wanted to show you guys a good before it goes in the hot tank and then an after. Yeah, this thing's pretty cool. It does a really good job without any kind of blasting. It's not as good as, say, a soda blaster, but yeah, anyway, you'll see. Check it out.
Take a look.
All right, guys, it's the next day. I let this thing sit overnight, this head bolt, head stud. I soaked it in oil and let it sit. Both of these, actually, the one that's already broke off and then this other one. I'm going to get them hot. I want to get this stuff fixed before we move on to the next step of this, which is actually prepping the deck and welding the decks. The first thing I do before we do all our machining processes. So I'm going to get this thing cherry hot again, let it cool off, maybe shock it with some oil, just try to get this sucker to move. Worst case scenario, I'll have to cut it off and then drill it or break it off and drill it or whatever. It's going to be kind of a challenge, but we're going to get it done.
All right, so getting these head studs out turned into a pain. As you can see, I couldn't get it out that way. Tried heating it up with a torch multiple times, letting it sit with oil on it. Ended up cutting the stud off, which felt wrong at the time because I have less to grab onto, but I did that in order to TIG weld this nut to the top of it. When you TIG weld the nut to it, it just puts way more heat in the cylinder head. I was able to work it out with the wrench then, which was pretty awesome. The other one, however, was broke off below the deck. Someone else had tried to drill it out at one point and failed miserably. They walked the drill bit on the surface and stuff. So I tried TIG welding onto that a couple times, couldn't get it out. So this was the process. I basically drilled it out, milled it out with an end mill because the hole was so messed up I couldn't actually just drill the stud out. And then I cut a old exhaust manifold up to use as a guide. I ended up putting a 7/16 20 bolt or 7/16 14 bolt in it, and then cutting that bolt off, milling that bolt head flat to the deck surface, and then using that exhaust manifold that I cut up as a template, putting an 8/125 bolt, like drilled and tapped that 7/16 bolt for an 8/125 bolt, and that's what we fixed the flange with. Yes, it was a huge pain, but kind of needed to do it, obviously, to fix, to save this head. These things are 40 years old. It's really hard to find them in perfect condition anymore. So it was a task, but we made it happen.
Alright, still dirty all around it, but got that hole fixed. Obviously, there's that hole there from whoever the previous person was that kind of walked the drill bit over, but nothing we're concerned about because this is all the gasket sealing area down here anyway, so it will not be a problem. But yeah, got to helicoil the rest of these and then move on to the next step with this thing.
All right, it fought us, but we're here, right? So on to the next step, guys. I'm gonna start grinding on the deck of this thing and get prepped to weld it. This process is called dry decking. If you want to learn more about that, I'll put a link in the description for a video I've done previously, and it explains why and more about the process.
All right, now that we got that thing welded, I'm gonna leave that head in the oven overnight. So I'm gonna call that the end of this video. So look out for the next one. In the meantime, check out this video about the basic porting of a 4G we do. It's kind of a porting overview that we've done, and see what you think of that. And look for the next one to come out. We'll move the guide heights in the next video, get those set, probably start working on the valve job, get that stuff done, and then move on to porting. The cylinder head is gonna be the next step of stuff we do.